It's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and yesterday we put up a video about setting up an Invisalign or clear correct case or any clear aligner case for an anterior bridge, specifically a Maryland bridge. We went over tricks and tips, and now we're going to do the opposite, setting it up for an Invisalign case for an anterior implant. So just some tricks and tips just to get things right in terms of the sequence of appointments, treatment planning, financials, everything like that. So it's going to be similar but different. This is going to be a little bit more difficult, not difficult, but maybe picky. And just a friendly reminder, I don't work for Invisalign, Align Technology, or Straumann, or any of these other companies. I just make content about their products so that you guys can learn to use it more efficiently and get better outcomes. But if anything I say is incorrect, one of these companies is welcome to contact me and I can modify or take down the post. Although I do really believe it's in their benefit for me to leave it up since I do these for free. Okay, back to the presentation. So for an Invisalign case, first thing you need to do is establish the team. So who's the team? Who's everyone that's going to be involved in this process? Because it's not just ortho. So let's establish the team. It might just be you. I mean, if you're really good at implants, you've done a lot of anterior implants. I mean, it could be you. You might be doing the ortho, delivering the implant, and restoring the implant. And if so, bravo. That's a lot of big money for you. Remember, anterior implants can be a little bit trickier to restore than posterior implants. Not so many general dentists do anterior implants. But there might be a periodontist involved to either place the implant or to graft. There might be an oral surgeon involved if you're not placing the implant or to graft. Make sure you're getting a proper CBCT, having it read, having a stent made, and doing things properly. Otherwise, you know, we want to set up the Invisalign case so that everything should be perfect when we're done and we don't have to go back and do it again. So get all your team involved to make sure you're doing things right, is which I'm get what I'm getting at. And then of course, the adjacent roots need to be parallel, because we don't want to be banging them or getting too close to a root as we drop this. And you need to make sure your size is big enough. A lot of times on these lateral cases, your upper twos, your 7 and 10, you know, it was a peg lateral and maybe we only have a space of 5.2 millimeters or something. That may not be big enough to drop an implant and restore a tooth. You know, you need a little bone on the other side of the implant. I mean, I'm told you could do a mini implant, but, you know, maybe you need to do a little lower IPR to make a little more space to make a little, so you could have a slightly bigger, more aesthetic implant. So just things to keep in mind. Now part of your team is going to be the restorative lab, getting involved with them and seeing what they think about the size of the implant and letting them see the Clincheck. So it's not going to be a fast Clincheck because you're going to, you know, basically going to have to sit down and have a meeting with them or export the Clincheck so that they can see it. So hopefully that helps, but lots of things to keep in mind. Also, just remember, you definitely want to be loading the implant so the opposite or the opposing tooth cannot be in contact. You have to have enough clearance both vertically and in an AP direction. So always make these cases Invisalign comprehensive so we can do it right or clear correct unlimited. All right, hopefully that was helpful. Thank you.